Here's a brand new top 10. It's my top 10 heckler riffs.
Heckler Countdown.
This countdown is all about clips where I went off on the same person for a while. I'm including the intros and pretty much the whole clip so you can get the context for each one. Having to watch these old intros, I realize that I am way happier now than I used to be.
Here's a clip.
Anyway, grab some popcorn and sit back because this episode is like an hour long. Not quite an hour, but it's close.
Number 10.
You need to know three things for this clip to make sense. One, I was filming it to submit for a possible special. Two, I had already talked about how I was 35 years old. And three, I was in the middle of a bit about how parents have an ego.
Sometimes the grandparent? Yeah. Congratulations, your children have fucked other people. You had nothing to do with becoming a grandparent. I hope you had nothing to do with becoming a grandparent. I hope you weren't just in there and be like, get him, get him! At some point, he's going to be a comedian, he's going to mention parents, and I'm going to have to one-up him, so he's going to be doing a bit about how parents are so egotistical, and we'll be like, well, wait till he sees what fucking grandparents do.
You're only 53. Yeah. That is not something to brag about. Let me just do the math for you, honey. You being only 53 is great, except in the... Hold on a moment, I have this one. But in the context of your children having children.
Yes.
That are how old?
They're 24, 25. I have...
The grandkids? Oh, for the love of God. Where the fuck did we...
I have 2 3-year-old grandkids.
You have 2 3-year-old grandkids. Okay.
One on the way.
Congratulations to your children who keep fucking like rabbits. And... that is something that I did. You're trying to high-five one who is so embarrassed right now. I don't know who else is on this table and how they know you, but they're pretending they don't. So, remember the part where I said I was going to film this to submit to television? Not fucking tonight. All right, so.
Cut to 32 minutes and a few drinks later.
Part of me wants to have a kid, just have like a good kid to counteract one asshole in the world, you know? Like, that's why I got a fuel efficient vehicle. Like, that's why... You are not making the point for me. It's like a cop giving a safety demonstration to his partner to shoot in the air while he's doing it. Like, this is not helping. Here's how to handle the gun. You're not driving home, are you?
How old are you?
How old am I? Do you think I turned 36 during the show? I'm 35. Still. I should wait. Okay, says the woman who was the grandmother 5 years after that. So, no, I know I did the math wrong. You were grandmother at 50, right? You were grandmother at 50, did I do the math right?
Grandmother 50, and now I'm...
Do you see how easy it is for me to pay attention to your age and your kids' ages? You didn't even know how the fuck old I was? 25, I know, but it's still... Holy shit. Has she never drank before? She's 54 years old. Is this really your first time drinking?
Yes.
Oh my god. Look at right now, okay. I don't know if you can see, but there are two people at the table just going like this right now. That's your family crest. That's what your family crest is. Just so with your hands on your face. Oh my god. I can't wait for you to explain to her tomorrow morning what the fuck happened today. Can I send you the tape? I have 3 cameras running in this room. I would like to send you multiple angles of what the fuck you're talking about. That is amazing. Oh. When your grandkids get married, please don't give the toast. Please don't. To my babies, I don't know how old you are.
We'll just play the video
tape. Just play the video tape of this? Yeah. Well, I'm definitely going to put this shit on YouTube. I'm definitely... If you see a clip that says, Grandma Heckler won't stop, that is your clip. I'm going to do it this. I have a solution, a real solution to all the ignorance and all the stupidity that we have in this world. It's going to come from the last place we'd expect. It's going to come from children.
Yes.
Two different people in the world call her Nana. They're two people. Can I meet those grandkids? And be like, just so you guys know, alcoholism might run in your family.
Number 9.
But your headliner's amazing. You're going to love him. You, less talkative. Now. He'll kill you. I promise you. That's my warning. I don't mind, but he'll destroy you.
I was in the middle of a story that took place in Laverne, California when this happened.
Or what? Levine? It could be Levine. What? Those are different words. See, Laverne is the name of a place that the story took place in. Or it could be Levine the city. You're just saying. Can you do me the favor and not say? Because you're sitting up front, you can't help yourself. No, I understand. You're sitting up front, you have to talk. Have you spoken? Give me 1 second. Have you spoken? Have the other two people in your own fucking party spoken? They are not in sales. Oh, you speak for a living. That is unfortunate. You're the one that Danny warned, right? Did you look up who you were coming to see before you came to see me? You just heard there was alcohol here. Oh, there's alcohol in the bar next door if you want to go there instead. You're going to enjoy it. Okay, because you paid. Here's the thing. Sit at other people. You said Levine because you understand it's Levine. No, it's Laverne. Were you there? Then why the fuck are you correcting me? It's Levine, Arizona. This happened in California. Where the fuck were you during this story? You're in the front row. How did it get lost from here to here? In 4 feet, that joke got completely lost. So what you're saying is, no, don't blame this shit on alcohol. They have drinks. They're all fucking calm right now. They have drinks and they're in the front row. I appreciate you blowing me kisses. I'm not catching any single one of those fucking things. I'm just letting those bounce off the wall right now. All right, miss, so you're in sales? No? You're in comedy. You're involved in comedy, but not the way you think you are. You're in comedy in the way that criminals are in law enforcement. You're part of the equation. But you're not the one in charge.
Number 8. I was at a show, and in the middle of telling a joke about how much I love pit bulls and how they get unfairly maligned, when someone's hometown pride got in the way, twice.
Each dog is an individual, and the media sensationalizes every story involving a pit bull to perpetuate that myth. Like, I read a story in Riverside, California. The headline said, what? Dangerous pit bull bites child. Are you cheering for Riverside? Were you trying to... As I'm telling you about a shitty thing that happened in your town. When I heard the cheer, I was like, I'm gonna let this go. I know this is a dumb place to cheer, but I'm not gonna say anything about it. Then you cheer a second fucking time. Just to make sure that everyone knew you were from your shitty little part of California. Even if I was complimenting Riverside, you still don't cheer for fucking Riverside. You still don't. Even if I was like, I'm gonna tell you the best thing about Riverside, you still don't cheer, because I probably just would have been like, they have auto malls. Like, that's probably the best thing about it. I mean, get a house there for 50 grand. That's... Not all the houses are on wheels. It's a great place. It's awesome. There are actually some houses there that might survive a good gust of wind. It's a great place. I'm sorry, you were cheering for something? So there was a story in Riverside, California. It's a place that nobody could... Yeah, you cheer again, go for it, yeah. Kidding, your town's fantastic. This is such a great place. Who was at the cheer? What's your favorite thing about Riverside?
I was like 15 minutes outside Riverside.
The 15 minutes outside Riverside. You're not even... So your favorite thing about Riverside is that you don't even fucking live there. Guess what, honey? That's also my favorite thing about Riverside. What?
Riverside County.
Riverside County. Okay, so you live in the county.
Yes.
Okay, so you're cheering for the city. If I talk about Syracuse, New York, nobody from New York City is like, that's also from the other place that I'm trying to find. Still called New York. What? You have to do it to see. Have to do, what do I have to do? I ain't gotta do shit. What do you think I have to do? Oh, now you're flipping me off? I gave you two different chances. I didn't respond to the first cheer, and after the second cheer, where I was a little bit mean, I went back into the joke, you interrupted me again, and now you're like, but now I'm mad. Like, you brought this on yourself. What town do you live in?
Norco.
What?
Norco.
Norco. No wonder you had to cheer for Riverside. What are the odds someone mentioned fucking Norco? What are the odds? What is the Norco? Is N-O-R-C-O? Norco. What is it? What's Norco known for aside from being 15 minutes outside of Riverside? And yet strangely in the same county. What?
Horse Capital USA.
Horse Capital USA?
Yeah, it's embarrassing, right?
No, it's just fucking wrong. That's Lexington, Kentucky. The Kentucky Derby happens in Kentucky. That's why I call it the Kentucky Derby. Happens in Louisville. All the horse farms are in Lexington. Horse Capital USA. There's one guy with a fucking pony. You guys aren't even the horse capital of Riverside County. There's no fucking way. I'm gonna Google the fuck out of this afterward. I'm just gonna look it up. I'm gonna look up Wikipedia, and Wikipedia is just gonna go, you're right, Steve. That's all it's gonna say. The horse capital of the world. How many horses do you export to other places in the world?
Honestly, people ride their horses to school.
That's not the horse capital of the world. That's the DUI capital of the world. Makes sense, because it's in fucking Riverside, so... I just wanted to talk about my dogs. That's all this was.
Number 7.
That's right, the Vikings raped a lot of people, and now I have red hair, and that is science. You like raping people? You said they like raping people. Okay, because I thought you said you like raping people. You might. I don't know. You guys have been talking the whole fucking show. You certainly like to do a lot of things I don't like doing. You're funny? You like funny? Okay, so shut the fuck up and listen to it once in a while. That's why you were doing... You're so drunk, I hope you drive home. I hope I just get to turn on the news. And I'm just like, oh, sometimes problems have a way of working themselves out. You gonna be okay? You have no hands. No, you have no tolerance. Is that what you have now? Oh. I remember the first time I drank. That was fun. I know. No one around you could hear the fucking joke either. That's been the issue for the last half hour. I feel like I've been very polite. I tried to soldier through. I tried to be like, no, I'm gonna fucking do this. I'm gonna talk over the TV show that's playing 2 feet in front of me. And I tried. And I couldn't anymore. What? Funny man's on stage. Yes. Now you see how this works. We do agree. I've been fucking trying to. There was no moment where I'm like, I'm just gonna stop telling jokes. Oh my God, it's gonna be so safe when you go home. I really did believe he said we like raping people. I really believe that. If anyone else had said it, I'm like, they're talking about Vikings. But that table said it, and I'm like, yeah, probably. Who am I to argue? I don't want to profile, but that's fucking true. All right. It is good. It just continue to be good. All right. We've played now. Your home version of this game is to shut the fuck up and let me play stand-up comedy. All right, this guy's got the vapors over here. That's great. I appreciate that, sir. Oh, you think you're better than everyone else because you bought a fucking Groupon. Your $5 bill. The most money you've seen in your fucking life. '92 Camaro. No shit, that's what you drive. I'm surprised you don't drive a fucking IROC. Do you hear all these people laughing at you? Does that show you're wrong? When you look at a room full of 100 people all laughing at you, does that give you a clue that you're fucking wrong? You don't have anything about you that rocks, sir. Except perhaps what's in your fucking head. All right. I tried to be polite. I really did. Sure, you meant the last one, too. All right, you ready to get back on track here? What was I talking about? Ignorance in America. So... I lose that train of thought.
Number 6. I was doing a free show at a bar in Spring Lake, Michigan, and it was packed. Because free crowds can get a little bit rowdy, they opened the show by warning everyone about my heckler clips, and they put special signs on each table warning people to keep their mouth shut. I was in the middle of telling a joke about how I don't like most people, and how Darwinism is a really good thing. Not only did someone interrupt, but he did something else I can't stand. He said empty words that mean absolutely nothing.
I don't think we need that person.
I want to know how you really feel.
You want to know how I really feel? Okay, well you came to a show where I talk for an hour, so you'll fucking learn. Are you surprised at how this is working right now?
I'm just waiting.
You're just waiting. Okay. It didn't seem like you were waiting, it seemed like you ran out of patience. The other people who kept silent, they were fucking waiting.
You're running out of money for shots.
You're running out of money for shots. Okay, well, how well you do at your job is not my concern. You don't have enough money, that's on you, buddy. That's not on me. The tickets were already free. I can't help you any further. There was no cover charge. I already got you because I'm fucking quicker, and that's why you should shut up and let me do this.
I like it.
You like it? Okay, so did they until this little exchange. I never got that, but tell us how you really feel. That's the most empty fucking sentence. It's a very empty sentence, because that's what I was in the middle of on purpose. So basically, what you mean to say is, hey, you're really passionate about this subject, and it's making me uncomfortable, because I'm not passionate about things myself.
True.
That where you were going?
True.
Okay. Well, next time, use those words instead.
I I learned something today.
Okay, good. So did everybody else. Don't fucking talk to me. That's what I learned. It's funny, I have a bit of a reputation that they announced before the show as someone who murders hecklers. And even that, you're like, I don't know if it's true. Let's see what happens. Let's poke a bear and see if it eats me. Okay. Here's the thing. I can't tell you how I really feel, because I was in the middle of a passionate bit, and then you interrupted it. Now if I go back in, it seems ungenuine. And that's what fucking happens when you interrupt someone. What did you want to have happen when you said that to me?
I want to laugh.
You want to laugh? Okay. And you weren't?
Yes.
You weren't laughing.
I was trying.
You were trying, but you were failing. The signal telling your brain was funny was trying to get to your mouth. And he was like, I want to laugh. And your mouth was like, nah. Instead, I'm just going to say, tell us how you really feel. Like it fucking means anything.
Yes.
Okay. So you weren't laughing at a free show.
Yes.
And you didn't realize you could leave. The shots were going good. No, you ran out of money for shots. You already told us that earlier. So let me see. You weren't enjoying the show. You were out of money to buy things. And then you were like, well, just stay here. You're a bad decision maker, sir. Did you know who you were coming to see when you came to see me?
No, I did not.
No? You're a bad decision maker, sir. Well, how about this? I'm going to tell all of them how I really feel. If it makes you uncomfortable, you can go. If you're okay with it, tell your mouth to fucking laugh. And we'll see how it goes. Okay? So my point is, I don't like people. Those of you who didn't laugh at that earlier, now you fucking know why. Stop saying things that mean nothing. That's what I'm talking about. No, that's what I was talking about. You weren't saying shit. You said one thing and meant nothing. You're like, let me say, do you also say working hard or hardly working? Where the fuck do you learn to talk? What do you do for a living, sir?
I own a building business.
You own a building business. You have employees who have to listen to you or they get fired?
We just
1099. You just 1099. Okay, wait, you own your own business and you can't afford shots. That's even funnier. You ain't building shit, sir. How much are shots?
$3.
$3, oh, fuck, man. I know Michigan's faced some hard times, but holy shit. How many did you have?
Three.
Okay. I know it gets real confusing after three. Four's next after that's five.
I went to nine.
How many did you have?
Probably nine.
Okay, that means six. Legitimately, how many did you have? Those others at the table that are sitting watching your friend twist in the wind, help me out.
Ask my waitress.
What?
Ask my waitress.
No, I'm not gonna bother her with your asinine shit. I'm gonna ask your friends. Wait, hold on a second. Did you really say two?
He said two.
Two.
Hold on. How many did he have?
Two.
Two? You broke drunk motherfucker. First of all, you lost count after two, which is amazing. Second of all, you own your own building business and you ran out of money at $6. Eight if you include tip. Wait a second, this guy. $6.50 if you include tip.
Probably 20%.
Okay, that's $1.20. I'm just trying to help you out because you're not going to get there on your own. But I'm just telling you how I really feel.
Number 5. I've told you before that I don't like being heckled. I prefer to just get through my set and do the material that I plan to do. But when it does happen, I'm damn glad I got it on tape.
See, most of you got that. If you're an American, you know what a kilo weighs, you're a drug dealer. Like, there's no other
option.
What?
You'd be a German.
Or you'd be a German. If you're an American, you'd be a German. Did you hear the setup to the... I said, if you're an American, you know what a kilo weighs, you'd be a drug dealer, or you'd be a German. Also, so fucking specific. You're one of three countries that don't use the metric system. One of three. And you're like, you'd be a German specifically. Doesn't every other country also use the metric system? Yes, but you'd clearly be a German knowing what a kilo weighs. I don't know what the fuck is going on over there, but let's just keep it there. Are we taping this, by the way? Because if we are, let me stay on this for another second. Were you so offended to your core that I didn't specify that Germans know a kilo's weigh? I just want to know what brought that out.
Your name is German, right?
My name is German. My last name is German. I'm not German, though. I don't know if you know, but back in the day, the Germans kind of went a lot of places. Took a few of us hostage and gave us some names we didn't fucking want, so... She was so like, but I think he's German the whole time. I think she was thinking that the whole fucking show. And just finally, because she heard the name, that are you German? Yes? What does Hofstetter mean in German? You're not fucking German, are you? You are, but not enough to know that it means city dweller. I know that because I went to Austria, where the name Hofstetter is everywhere, because Germany kind of started that way. That was kind of their first, that was like their test country. They were like, let's see how that, yeah, we can take that one. All right, let's go. Welcome to the parlor for your history lesson. I apologize for lashing out, but I'm Jewish. We've got a bit of a history. There are some very lovely German people, but not the ones that gave me my fucking name, I'll tell you that.
Number 4.
When this happened, I had just been telling a story about how a cop annoyed me a little bit, and I wanted to get revenge on him.
And here's why I do that, because one of you will help me get my revenge. I don't know who it'll be. Maybe someone here tonight. Maybe you'll be... Someone said you want to kill him. That's not the revenge I want. You don't know where I'm going, but that's what you assume? One of you will get my revenge. I mean, like, embarrass him slightly on stage as a comic. You're like, I'm going to kill him. I'm like, that's not... I don't think you're allowed to... I don't think I snap. You said to kill him. You... What?
Have you ever seen Snapped?
Have I ever seen Snapped? No, but... Hold on a second. Snapped is the show where all the women snap and kill their husbands. Sir, do you know that she watches this show? All I said was, let's get revenge on a cop. She's like, kill him? We're going to kill him? Are we going to kill him? We're going to kill him, right? I saw Snapped. I have this whole thing. I love you, honey. Like, what the hell?
He hates the narrator.
He hates the narrator, so that's why he doesn't watch. Not because you're planning his murder. But because the narrator is a little... It's like he hates the narrator, so I only assume that he'll kill him one day. Because that's what you do when you're mildly annoyed at something. Well, this went off the rails. This was different than I was planning.
You wanted engaged.
I wanted engaged?
You wanted an engaged audience.
I wanted an engaged audience. I did. I didn't want one planning murder. That's a... You know what? This is my fault. I wasn't really paying attention when I started the show. Maybe I accidentally said, hey guys, we're going to murder somebody at the end of this. I remember talking about how, like, you, if you're an asshole, work that out by the construction and murder people. Like, I don't remember that part. It was... Hey, Louisville, what's up? How are you? This is... You from Louisville?
Actually, no.
Just moved here. On the run? didn't want engaged, but I can play with it. So what was your fake job and your last identity? Now, if you're going to suggest murdering a police officer, I'm going to talk to you. I didn't plan on talking to the audience, but that's not one you can just say and then be like, oh, go on. You can't. Wait, hold on a second. You all need to hear this shit. She just said, well, my husband's older than me, so he moved here for me, and I'm in the prime time of my career. He's not dying.
I don't know.
I mean, if you keep killing cops, probably he'll get mowed down. What do you do? 30, what, you're in your 30s? How old are you?
I just turned 39 yesterday.
Turned 39 yesterday. Well, happy birthday. I don't know if you know this, but that's not the retirement age. That's your goal retirement age. What is it that you do for a living?
Interior design.
Interior design. Oh, yeah, you could totally retire by 39. Interior design in Kentucky, the home of interior design. Just one double wide at a time, you can just fix this place up. I had a very good cop story, and I was going to tell it.
Number 3.
Timed, but true. I hope you meant like because of Paris Hilton, not because of my show. Like, how dare you? It's less talented people making more money than you do. You're in college, though, right? What?
I knit.
You knit?
Yeah.
And you're worried that people make money than the lucrative field of knitting? You know, hey guys, I did watch the knitting championships on ESPN 14, and don't get me wrong, I think Paris Hilton shouldn't make a dime for anything other than shutting the fuck up, but in fairness, you might want to turn pro in something other than knitting if you want to clean up above the heiress to a hotel fortune. And shit for the Hiltons, that'd be... And now a new bedspread. Let's go. Alright, are you knitting right now? You're knitting right now. She always does. I hope she always does. I hope she just wasn't like, fuck this guy, I'm gonna knit. What is it that you were knitting right now?
A scarf.
A scarf? Well, sure. It's the perfect time to knit a scarf. To buy a scarf because they're cheap as shit right now, but this is why you're making no money knitting. Scarves in April, you really gotta time things better. Holy shit, this is fantastic. Get a blanket for an insomniac next, it'll work out great. Trying to help you with a business plan. I don't know. Leg warmers for an amputee. I don't know what else you want to do. I bet that's an untapped market. I bet no one's even thought of doing that before. How many scarves have you knit?
Several
over the years. Did you start in the winter and it just takes that long? When did you start the scarf?
I started this a few weeks ago, but
never hurts to prepare for winter. Well, sure, that's... You'll be very prepared. Before that, it was dice bags. That would have been more of a summer activity. Hard to roll dice in the winter. But with the snow, you're like, come on, 7, now they're gone. That's unfortunate. Knit scarf bags in the summer, scarves in the winter. Just trying to help with the business plan. Have you ever applied for a grant? Have you seen very concerned about the money you're making with scarves. What year in school are you? You're just a freshman. So, okay. So the scarf money really comes by junior year. Because by then you have a lot of contacts on campus, and you can just show up and be like, want to buy a scarf? Really, that's not even a coat. That's another scarf. That's a scarf to me. It's a talent, you know, the scarves. Okay. I'm going to buy a scarf off this young lady. How much do you sell your scarves for? Depends on what type you're making. Well, I didn't realize there were so many classes of scarves. I am new to the scarf industry. I mean, that's why you need, well, dice, sure, I know dice, but scarves. I do the different classes of balls? Well, I'm pretty sure I've just been doing 5 minutes of ad-lib. I got balls, all right? Don't fuck with me and my balls.
Next year it'll work, even though it's their microphone.
think of anything knit that I would need. I was trying to think. I'm like, oh, well, it's getting into summertime. Maybe you can knit me a...
sweatband?
A sweatband. I don't think that would be comfortable. All yarn was itchy. Well, not all yarn is itchy. Well, clearly I know that. I mean, who doesn't know that? I didn't know that. Well, no, it's not all itchy, but I can't imagine a knit sweatband. And I don't mean to cast aspersions into the fantastically lucrative field of knitting. I don't think sweatbands are your major market. I think you really should study up on what you should knit before you worry about Paris Hilton's money. And that's how this all started, I think. That's how this started. I was like, Paris Hilton, 10 minutes of knitting. That's what happened. That's why you go to a live show, because you never know when Paris Hilton is going to lead to... You should knit her a fucking gag. That would be awesome. Knit Paris Hilton a gag.
Number two.
Every now and then, a heckler just walks into material.
And I know that there are parents in the room tonight. For the parents in the room, I want to make sure you know this. You're not special. And I'm tired of your shit. Because parents walk around like having a kid makes you special, and that's not true. Raising a good kid, that makes you special.
Statistically, too many of you are applauding, but...
right now, like, that's true. Mine's in juvie, but I put someone else. Someone else. Mine's got this meth problem, but it's someone else. It's gonna be great. It takes more effort to order a pizza than it does to have a child.
Bullshit.
Well, tell me. Hold on, I got this. Tell me this. What? Has anyone ever ordered a pizza by accident? Yeah, just open the door and have this pizza get here!
I was hoping God would stop the pizza. I can't handle a whole pizza, I'm only 15.
I'm very upset by this. I said I haven't had any.
Alright,
then
you don't know anything about children, so what the hell do you know about pizza?
First of all, I've had a lot of fucking pizza. Here's the thing. You can't just say, well, you haven't had any kids, so you don't know anything about kids. Because here's the thing. I've never flown a helicopter. If I saw one in a tree, I could still be like, dude fucked up.
Not supposed to be up there. That's pilot error.
I don't expect a pilot to get all pissed at me like, until you've understood the pressures of flying a helicopter, you can't possibly know what it's like to fly a helicopter. I've got 3 helicopters, I haven't slept in months. Like, no. I get what you're saying, but when something's fundamentally wrong, you can just tell. You a sports fan, Romus?
Pardon?
You a sports fan? Sure. Who's your favorite team?
Oh, Redskins.
Redskins. Big Redskins fan. Do sometimes when the Redskins play and they don't win, do you get mad?
No, I get upset, but I don't get mad.
Upset, but you don't get mad. Well, let me rephrase my question. Do you ever get upset?
I'm a Redskins fan, do or die.
You're a Redskins fan, do or die. Well, have you ever played professional football? So what the fuck do you know about football now?
Number one!
Celsius, right?
Celsius up there? Well, yes, but I'm not going to tell the joke in Celsius in America.
Oh my God, I was driving. I had to go so many meters. You guys understand, right?
Yeah, next joke I'll tell in French. How about that, huh? They'd understand it in Quebec. Why not down here? You want to translate the joke to the Celsius for our Canadian friends that clearly there are so many of them? I mentioned Canada. One girl went, hee, and that was all.
But thanks for pointing that out. There was a moment in his head where he's like, this is the right thing to say. Like, before it came out, we all have thoughts, and most of us just kind of swat the thoughts back. We're like, no! You get out of here, dumb thought. You stay home. He's like, oh, dumb thought. Go play. Be free. So the answer, no, not in Celsius is the answer. I know what that is in Celsius. 27 below? You're trying to figure out what it is. Good. Now so are 200 other people.
If you want more content like this, subscribe. And when you do, make sure to click that little bell so you get a notification whenever I upload anything new. For a chance to win all 6 of my albums, you can comment on this video. And to see me live, go to stevehofstetter.com. I have a crazy tour coming up. I'm performing in 5 cities in Australia. Perth, Adelaide, Sydney, Melbourne, and Brisbane. But before I do that, I'll be doing 5 shows in Reno, Nevada this weekend. Or Nevada. Or however the fuck it's pronounced. I don't really care. The point is, I'll be there. Get your tickets now and see where else I'm performing at stevehofstetter.com.